said, once again, you have brought up a very, very intense question. Actually, a few of them. Is it more scary to die alone or to live a life where no one would know that you died? Now, because of my physical circumstances, I have dealt with the fear of death. I have had circumstances that have brought me to death's door. But I didn't walk through it. So this is like a really big question in my life. It's something that I deal with, I have dealt with a lot in my life. Even before I got sick, I had a fear of dying. I grew up in a household which circumstances could have led to death on occasion. Now, with my physical circumstances, I have been in the hospital with different situations. So the fear of death has come. Am I afraid of dying alone? Yes. I do live alone. See, that's a yes and no answer for me, I guess. I really tried to ponder this, but I wanted to get this attention quickly because, you know, sometimes when you put things off, you don't put everything in you want to say. You think about your response too long, and then it isn't quite as raw or as real as it could have been. So forgive me if it's a little bit jumbled. Basically, excuse me. Basically, yes, I have had the fear of death. But I don't live in the fear of death. When it comes, I deal with it. And I have different tools to deal with it. Am I afraid of living a life where if I died, no one would know? I don't really fear that. Not because, you know, I'm like this really whatever, you know. I mean, it's not like, you know, like super miss popular, but those that are a part of my life and care about me would know. And so no, I'm not really afraid of that. I'm not really afraid of dying and not having made an impact. Again, not because I'm puffing myself up, but because I know that every day I make a conscious effort to use my life in a way that is going to be beneficial for others. That means that I'm going to be a fighter. That means that I'm not going to let go. I hold on with everything in me. And I take life and I grip it. And I use it. And those that I get to have the privilege of being in their lives, that's a big honor to me. I don't take it lightly. I think this is a very important thing for people to question. Not because of fear, but because of making your life last. Making it worthwhile. That's why I say so many times, be passionate. Use what you've got. We don't always take what we have and use it. And you know what? Why not? Everybody has something to give. Everybody has something special about them. Everyone. We have a lot we are capable of. We are capable of great, great love and great blessing. That's what we should be doing. These kind of questions are important. So Sid, I say thank you. These are important questions to ask. We need to be woken up. We need to be challenged. We need to think about what we're doing in our daily lives. How are we acting with one another? How are we giving to one another? How are we challenging one another? And life is fragile. So live it. Enjoy it. Take it and go with it. Don't be afraid. Don't live in fear. Keep going. So basically, what I'm saying is I encourage you all, live your life, okay? If you're sick and you deal with disease, your doctor doesn't know everything. If your doctor's handed over a death sentence, change the sentence. Don't live under condemnation. Don't live under fear. Now you can deal with fear like I do on a daily basis, but it's not going to rule you. It's not going to rule me. We have a choice in this. Fear is real, but you can go on. You can function even if you're fearful. You can do things even if you're afraid. So make the choice to change your sentence. Make the choice to change the way you think about things, the way you think about fear, rather than living in it, dealing with it, and going forward, you know? There are times when I just have to do it afraid. I just have to go on and do it afraid. Because fear is not going to be what rules my life. I want to be free. I want to live in freedom. I want to live in peace. I want to live in comfort. And I can't be all those things and be fearful. You know? So, it's just, for me, I can't be hopeful and fearful at the same time. So, again, I encourage you. Just love life. Just take it in. Just go for it. Don't be afraid. Whatever situation you're in, even if you're laying in bed, you have something you can do. Go for it. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Y'all have a great day. Thank you for listening to my thoughts.